views and opinions expressed in this program are those of the participants and do not necessarily reflect the views of BronxNet or the program underwriters.
And good morning, everybody. Welcome to Open, the one and only show that opens up the Bronx and the world to you. I'm your host, the Dr. Bob Lee. We've got a great show lined up for you today. Woo! On the heels of everything that was happening yesterday and over the weekend. Coming up on today's show, the 6th Annual Job Expo at the Bronx Library Center. It's coming up and we'll preview what you can expect and how to prepare for it. Plus, we'll sit down with an artist working to revive and renew Boogaloo. Can you do the Boogaloo? The Boogaloo music. We're going to check it out in New York City. And after that, trainer Tracy Knott, he stops by. Watch out when he stops by. He's going to know he has a powerful workout that he wants you to check out. I'm not going to get involved. I'm going to watch. I hope you watch, too. Then we'll take a good look at a night of music and empowerment with evangelist Valerie Boyd. She's going to be here. Then later on today, our Music Monday stage features a young rapper inspired by hip-hop. Stay tuned. All this and more is headed your way because we are now open. I'm your host, the Dr. Bob Lee, and you're watching Open. It's the one and only live interactive program that brings the Bronx and New York City straight to your TV set. We want to encourage you to stay connected to us. You can tweet us at BronxNet TV and follow us on Facebook at Open BronxNet Television. Leading off the show on September the 21st, it's coming right around the corner. Time is flying. We got the Bronx Library Center's 6th Annual Job Expo. It returns to the Boogie Down Bronx. And joining us with the details, we have Senator Gustavo Rivera. He's in the house. Give him a big round of applause. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Thank you.
Career coach Robin Sanders. She's in the house. Give her a big round. Yeah, yeah. And community board 7 chair Adeline Walker. Welcome to the show.
She gets an applause too, doesn't she?
Yeah, give her a big round of applause. Yeah. I was waiting for you.
Can't do one or two. You got to do 3 of them.
You got all 3. But I was waiting for you.
Well,
I thought maybe everybody.
I stepped up to the plate, sir.
I thought maybe everybody caught in after the 2, you know. How are you guys?
Doing excellent.
I'm fine.
Always
great.
A pleasure. This great Monday morning. Hope you guys had a wonderful weekend, did you?
Yes.
Yeah.
Restful.
Yeah.
You know, yes. Robin, now, you know, you've been doing this for a while. Tell us about what's going on this time.
Well, it's the 6th annual Job Expo at the Bronx Library Center. We're excited. Each event is, it just inspires people to take advantage of and become a part of it. Uh-huh. They send their friends, their families, and so on and so forth. So we're delighted to have a lot more, of course, employers to participate this time around. In addition to Montefiore and AHRC, which is social service and developmentally challenged, that whole thing. We've got a lot more education, a lot more educational jobs.
Community Board 7 is involved?
Oh, yeah.
What?
Yes. We work all together, the senator here and the library and all the elected officials that are involved. We are working together as a community to make sure people have jobs. Because when you walk in and you see the amount of people that she has there to offer you a job, you're going to walk out knowing you have something valuable. These are companies that are very reputable. And what Robin didn't mention is she's already got 2,000 people registered for this event. So you want to be there on Wednesday at 11 o'clock, I would say get in line early. Because this is going to be the biggest event. And you're going to walk in and you're going to meet people like the Board of Prisoners. You're going to see institutions that are looking for doctors and lawyers and all kind of positions and chefs. So we want everyone to come out, because when you go home and you get a good job and you come home and say, I've got something, you have a sense of pride. You know that you're a person that can contribute to your family and to your welfare. So that's what we're looking for.
Yes, and a senator came by, he said, you know what? This is something I can get behind.
Indeed. We'd actually been working with Robin for the last couple of years, and I cannot give her enough props. Her and the Bronx Library Center, and by the way, if you have not gone, if the people that are watching have not gone to the Bronx Library Center, they are missing out a lot. Yeah. Not only is it one of the libraries that is visited the most in the entire system, but this is the type of event that happens there every other day. And this is the sixth year that we're doing it. One of the things that Robin always stresses, and my office has been working with her to make sure that this happens, is that we bring employers that are from the Bronx that have jobs available. You know, it's good to have a table of somebody saying, hey, these are some of the things that we potentially could do.
Yeah, yeah.
But if there's no jobs there, then that's not, it's not that positive.
I come for just branding. Hey,
precisely.
I don't have any jobs, but I just want to put my name
and
out there.
And as far as the people that have registered already, it's both a pro and a con. Mm-hmm. The pro is that obviously we've done our job in getting the information out there, and more people after they watch this will sign up. Unfortunately, there are not 2,000 jobs available in there, but you should go, because not only will it give you an opportunity to potentially get a job, but also to make your resume better, to get a sense of the things that you can do or should be looking for. Mm-hmm. And it's something that we do every single year. We help hundreds of people find jobs and make sure they're prepared to get jobs.
Senator, I like you. You ever think about doing radio?
I don't think that there's too much competition in the radio already. Plus, I got this other job, this other gig.
Yeah, this
other like gig. This whole tenant thing.
Yeah,
this,
yeah.
It kind of takes up a little bit of my time.
Oh, you do well.
Oh, that's funny.
So what's it going to look like when we get there?
Well, when you get there, you're definitely going to have to sign up. You're going to walk in and you'll be escorted to the auditorium. And employers are going to come out and they're going to talk about the opportunities that they have available. Patrons will be given a sheet so that way they can sign off, check off what tables that they want to visit to get the most out of. It'll move quickly in that fashion.
Yeah.
But at least the patrons get the opportunity to not only hear, but they become proactive in what it is that they're trying to look for. So they get to check it off and they can go directly to that particular employer. So if they're not interested in one area, they can go into another area, which is awesome.
Yeah. Who are some of the sponsors working with you guys?
This type of interview, usually you probably discourage from carrying notes with you. This is a moment when we need those dang notes, because there's so many different folks that are actually helping us out. Certainly some of the big ones that we mentioned already, whether it's my office, the community board, and the library center, as well as Montefiore. But then we have a whole lot of different employers from every type of employer.
Yeah.
So whether we're talking about security, talking about culinary services, whether we're talking about medical services, educational, and everything in between, we have jobs available. So this is, again, one of the places where hopefully there's like something that's happening right below us right now on the TV screen, where there's a list of people that are there. It's like, that would be the best way to do it, because there's so many that have made themselves available that we can't just imagine, you know, remember them all right now.
We got another stage for you. We're going to set it up over there for stand-up.
Do it.
But you definitely can find it on the website of the New York Public Library.
There you go.
And it has a list of not only the employers, but definitely the educational institutions, as well as the social service entities, community-based organizations. There's a whole list that individuals can check out.
And this is very important, because people, especially our viewing and listening audience, they want to find out what's going on in the community. They want to know that, you know, hey, I have an opportunity to go to get a job. And not only that, Robin, it starts from the bottom to the top. You help them out with the resume.
Absolutely.
Talk about that.
And so when most of the time we meet with individuals who don't have one, and so in working with a person with their resume, there's a whole host of other things that happens at that meeting. So we do that interview prep, that, you know, the mock interviews, the question and answer, and we talk about there's no need to be nervous, there's nothing that anybody can take away, but they can always add to it.
Mm-hmm.
What we do is we kind of build them up so that way they can feel confident enough to go out there to get the positions that they're looking for.
Yeah.
So,
And I should tell you, Doctor, that it's something that happens year round in that. What is the name of the program that you lead, Robin?
The Career Education Information Services.
Education Information Services, CEIS. And that's something that exists in the library year round. So whether this is a big job fair, so we have hundreds and hundreds of jobs under one roof, but every other day of the year that the library is open, CEIS is there making sure that people can be prepared for any job interview that they might have, or prepare a resume, et cetera. It's something that she does every single day over there.
Or even prepare for college, yeah, you know? Yeah. And so we kind of prepare our students or those seeking to go into school the steps in terms of what we should do in order to get you affiliated with the school. Our thing is careers, but it's really about education. The more that we educate ourselves, the more that we can create our own path, and that leads us to the careers that we want. So my thing is definitely, or our thing per se, is definitely education as well as the careers.
Let people know how they should come down. How should they dress?
That's maybe like this, Rob.
Yes.
Look at that with the purple thing of the tie with the thing with the fin stripes. This is nice. I like this.
Bring your resume.
Oh, yes, that too. But you're saying resume. As far as, we already talked about the resume.
Yeah.
As far as the dressing, they should, you know, it's always said you should dress for the job that you want, right?
Yes.
And that's always, you should dress professionally. And be prepared to be there for a while. But yeah, again, this is a good getup right here.
All right, so wear your suit and tie. Mm-hmm. You know, do the best you can.
I just want to share something else about Robin.
Sure.
Every job fair, she sets up a section for veterans.
Oh, yeah.
So she has the VA hospital, she has the Veterans Career Center come, she has a whole slew of organizations that geared to getting jobs for veterans.
Yes.
And that's very vital that we support the veterans of our community. Not only that, she's the chair of our Veterans Committee on our board. She's a great asset to this community wholeheartedly. So this, her fairs are superb. So if you're going to get a job, it's got to be through Robin and her library, because that's the best place. I remember us having a job fair last year for veterans. We had 1,500 people around the block. Do you know, and we had one recently with Senator Gustavo at mm-hmm. Lehman College. Mm-hmm. They were both a big success. But what makes it great is when you see people come out of there and say, I cannot believe it. And I said, what happened? I thought something happened. No, I got a job right on the spot. So yeah, this is what we're looking for people to come up and tell us mm-hmm. that, because that's the most exciting moment.
Yeah.
I've watched it happen. I came to one of them and watched it put
you're invited to this one too, dude.
I'm invited.
You better come.
Yes, you
are.
You better
come.
Yes.
But then you show up and people are like, you got jobs? That's what they're going to ask you.
Yeah.
They're going to want to have your autograph.
And they do every day.
Yes.
Where can we go for more information on this?
You can go to newyorkpubliclibrary.org for more information.
You can also call my office. That's 718-933-2034. I say again. 718-933-2034.
And you can call our Community Board 7, which is on 204th Street in the Bronx, at 718-933-5650.
Give them all a big round of applause, everybody. Robin L. Sanders, career coach, NYPL, Gustavo, the Honorable Gustavo Rivera, New York Senator, District 33, and Adeline Walker, Community Board 7. I just threw the Adeline. So we have to take a quick break. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you.
We'll take a quick break, but stay tuned. We'll be right back with more Open next.
It's a pleasure.
And best friends.
I love my sister.
My heart doesn't see race. Love is love.
Our family is no less than any other family.
Love is kind. Love is patient.
Take a look under your bed. Find stuff under there? What about jobs? No? Now try your closet. Still no jobs, just more stuff? Well, you really have both. See, stuff is defined as household articles considered as a group. Sometimes this stuff is no longer needed. Wait, no longer needed? That can't be right. Because remember those jobs you were looking for? Those are really needed. And they're the stuff inside your stuff. Our job is to unlock those jobs. And it starts when you donate your stuff to your local Goodwill. Here's how we do it. When you donate to Goodwill, we sell your stuff to provide job training for people right here in your community. So just by teaming up with Goodwill, you help create jobs. And isn't that worth parting with the leftover keytar from your 80s cover band? Goodwill. Donate stuff. Create jobs.
It's not always easy being a dad.
Do you have panda asthma too? Does that run in the family?
This is the home of the most priceless kung fu artifacts.
But when you make an effort...
Dad, we're not supposed to touch anything.
Oh, sorry.
Go along, son!
It's always worth it.
Whoa! Master!
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life. Take time to be a dad today.
I am gonna get you. I'm gonna get you.
Call 877-4DAD-411 or visit fatherhood.gov to learn more.
Your daughter just had her first breakup. Do you A, put yourself in her shoes? B, console her?
Don't worry, sweetie. This is gonna happen a lot.
Or C, find her a new boyfriend.
Nice single boys. That was weird.
As a parent, there are no perfect answers. But you don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same.
And welcome back, everybody. Hey, you know, our next guest is the founder of Spanglish, Spanglish Fly, a unique brand of, it's a band, a unique band, bringing Boogaloo back to New York City. And we're going to explain. I have Jonathan Goldman here. Welcome to the show.
Nice to meet you, Bob. Thanks a lot.
Do the Boogaloo.
I'm not going to get up and do some dancing right now.
No, I'm not asking you to do it, but to explain.
Yeah, so Boogaloo was a genre in the 1960s. Yeah. It had its brief little heyday and then sort of got railroaded out by salsa.
Yeah, a lot of people did songs like Do the Boogaloo and the disco era came in and soul and all of that stuff.
Yeah, I mean the big songs from the Latin Boogaloo genre were We Like It Like That and Bang Bang, El Pito.
Bang Bang.
That one, there you go.
We like it like that.
That's see, they sound the same.
We like
don't they?
It, baby. I'm
doing you can a whole tell remix. It's the same genre.
So tell us about what you're doing.
Well, we're bringing Boogaloo music back. We're inspired by all the great bands from the 1960s, Joe Cuba and Mongo Santa Maria and Pete Rodriguez, ooh, Joe Batten, etc. And we're trying to recreate it and bring it to audiences of today, but also. We enjoy it when people who knew the music back in the day get to come to our shows.
Now, a lot of these artists are still, well, not all of them, but I know Joe Patan, he's
having performing. His own revival right now.
Yes. Yeah. So you have a band. How many pieces?
11 pieces.
11 pieces.
Yeah. Spanglish Fly, that's the band.
Spanglish Fly, 11 pieces.
Yeah, that's what we're here for.
And you guys travel all over?
Well, we travel when we can. You know, it's hard to get 11 guys on an airplane, but... We toured up and down the East Coast, and we mostly play around the New York City area. Mm. We're all from here.
What made you want to bring back the Boogaloo?
Well, a few years ago, I got really into it when I was DJing, and then I was
You're a DJ?
Bring
out the turntables. Here we go.
You know, here's my proof. Right
I see it. That's for 45 there. Yeah. Here's a 45 disc on there. Show that. Zoom into that thing right here. A lot of people don't know what that is.
Yeah, well, there's a 45 adapter. Yeah. So I used to collect 45s, and I was doing a lot of DJing, and I got really into Boogaloo music. And then I was waiting. I was thinking, somebody's got to bring this music back and start playing it live again in New York City. Well, no one did, so I said, I guess I got to do it myself. So I started the band about five, 6 years ago. And anyway, we've been playing around the city ever since.
I like it. Do the Boogaloo. Are we going to hear some of it, or... Are you going to bring the band here one day, or?
Well, we're playing in Flushing Town Hall.
Here.
I'll bring a three-piece right here to the studio.
Yeah, yeah.
What would that be? Maybe timbales, piano, and me on the trumpet. Yeah, yeah. So
the rhythm section at least.
So usually we play with 10 or 11 people. It's hard to cut down to three.
I know.
If only three guys show up to a rehearsal, it's not a very good rehearsal.
I know, it's not a good thing. Yeah. But put the rest on tape.
Yeah, right. Karaoke booth.
Yeah. You'll see one guy come in and he has a machine doing all the rest. And
just a laptop.
Yeah, that's right. Or thumb drive.
Well, I can give you this right here. This is our new record.
Look
Spanglish
at that.
Fly, New York Boogaloo, with a record cover designed by Izzy Sanabria, who did a
I
lot
know
of
Izzy.
The, you know Izzy.
He's a DJ, yeah.
Yeah. Well, he did a lot of the record covers for Fania back in the 60s and 70s. And so he's that's part of the revival thing. We got him to do our record too.
Izzy Sanabria.
Yeah, they called him Mr. Salsa.
He has a place off of the New York Sound here. Nice little house in the back there. Really nice. We went to his house one day.
Oh.
BronxNet shot some things there. And he did a CD, I think he did a record with the BronxNet.
Uh-huh.
But our executive director knows. But this is really, really nice. And you know, vinyl is coming back.
Yeah. Yeah,
everybody's talking about it.
Yeah, and a lot of there are a lot of DJs out there looking for new vinyl.
And there's somebody all the way in town from England looking to collect vinyl. You have any vinyl you want to?
Collecting. Yeah, well, I got plenty of these.
There you go. Where can we get this? Is it in stores now?
It's in stores, and really, it's maybe we could have a little thing along the bottom, like your last guest said, saying all the stores, but the easiest way is to go to the Spanglish Fly website, which is spanglishfly.com. But don't forget that G in the Spanglish.
Now, you played with a lot of other artists, right? Did you play with the Sanabria?
If you mean Bobby Sanabria, I've had the pleasure of joining him on stage.
You have?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. But that was because we played at the center that he and his wife Elena Martinez run, and he joined us on stage. But I've never actually been in his band.
But you've been around.
I've been around. Yeah.
So what's coming up?
Flushing Town Hall on Friday. That's this coming Friday. That's what is that? September 23rd. We're playing at 8 o'clock. There's a Boogaloo dance lesson at 7 o'clock. So that's in Queens. That's our next show. After that, we've got a bunch of other shows coming up. SOBs in November, and we're playing the Shrine in Harlem in October. Yeah. Part of a festival called the Honk Festival.
I like it. You're going to be around. Yeah. So wait a minute. And the one in Flushing, 137th Street, that's just past Shea Stadium. You go across the little bridge, go up to 137th. It should be right in that area. Right,
it's something like that. I mean, all I know is I'm getting on the fabled 7 train.
There you go.
And then at some point, I get off and walk.
There you go. Beautiful, beautiful. Okay. So we can go to what site now?
Spanglishfly.com. That's right.
And everything is right there.
It's pretty easy once you get on the site to navigate.
And all the information from where you're going to appear.
All our shows are listed, and lots of videos to watch. You can see what we look like live by going to the site, and then you'll decide for yourselves. I want to come see that show.
Yeah.
I expect to see you there, Bob.
Are you going
to
DJ there also?
I'm not DJing.
You should put a little DJ set next to it, too. Hey, look, we're going to add a little something to it.
Right, a little scratching over the Boogaloo while it's being played live.
Yeah. Hey, this is great.
I like that.
This is mine?
That's yours now.
Can you sign it?
Yeah, sure.
There you go.
Know, in blood, if I can, because I don't have a pen.
Well, let me see. I have a little safety pin here.
Safety pin?
Yeah, you just trick your fingers. Right. Nobody kidding. Give him a big round of applause, everybody. Jonathan Goldman, founder Spanglish Fly. Here it is. Pick it up. It's in stores now. Spanglish Fly. All right, we've got to take a quick break, and we'll be right back. We'll return with trainer Tracy Knott. The trainer's in the house. The court officer. Don't miss it. We'll be right back.
I wanted to kind of just work my way in, catch the ball, catch things that are in front of me, make the plays that are presented to me. But, you know, to make a game-winning touchdown catch a week ago and to come in and make a pretty decisive catch on the sideline to pretty much seal the game, I mean, I can't draw it up any other way, man. I don't know, you know, I just go out there and play the game. And I think I'm getting better as these weeks go on, as these practices continue. And I just want to continue to build off that.
What was the game plan coming in, and did you guys feel like you executed what the coach had in mind?
Yeah, definitely. Just stop the running. Definitely get Brees off the spot and King, so he doesn't see those open receivers if we have any. All right, and just make a play when he throws the ball.
Presenting the first MC of the 21st century, Rajoo.
with a message, Grandmaster.
You gotta learn your body, pace yourself, and have fun. So let's go have fun. Let's go do it.
The tricky thing about shoulders, your shoulders is a three-tier muscle. You have your front delt, you have your rear delt, and you have your mid delt. So when you're working out your shoulders properly, you have to do three different exercises.
It's wonderful being able to compete with a lot of these young guys from all over the world. It's important to stay in shape.
David Lesh, legal correspondent to the morning show Open. If you have a legal question that you'd like me to answer, please send me an email at davidlesh@bronxnet.org and I will address it on our Ask Your Lawyer segment.
Hello, good people of the Bronx and beyond. Welcome to A Life in Art.
Donating it to Goodwill may be the most incredible of all. Goodwill. Donate stuff. Create jobs.
Welcome back. Our next guest is trainer Tracy Knott with the knockout punches. He's here with some powerful workout tips. Welcome, Tracy Knott, everybody. Give him a big round of applause. You came through the rain, huh?
That's right, man. Yeah. It was tough this morning, but we got here. So.
All right. So what do we have here?
These are, well, of course.
What are these things called?
These are steppers with risers. I like to use them. I incorporate them with my classes.
You can go as high as you want.
Of course,
keep
of course. I just brought the little baby stuff for now.
Yeah, it's all right. You'll feel that after a while.
Yeah, but you're going to do it.
I'm going to do it?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
So I always work on that core area. But what a lot of times with muscle memory, a lot of times when you're squatting, you just go but so far. And then you're not really
excelling. It's like me.
Right.
I'm going to go so far.
You go right in here, you know. So what I like to do is bring bounding in. How bounding helps you is that you have to stop your body weight. Mm-hmm. So, of course, it builds more, too, and you get more range into it.
So you're into cardiovascular and
big
all that?
Time. Big
What's
time.
The best muscle that you talk about mostly? The muscle that...
Heart, baby.
Heart,
baby. That's what it's
the
about.
The heart muscle.
I mean, we've spoken about this numerous times. You see people in great shape, and, you know, they're not with us anymore because they didn't take care of the diet. And
you gotta take care of that main muscle.
That's right, man. That's what that's about. I don't care how you're looking as far as your muscles going on, but if you're not taking care of that heart, I mean, it's not a smart thing to do.
And then one of the other important things is that core.
Core, baby, core. Right. That's the lower back, the glutes, and the abs. That's the strongest part of your body.
Yeah.
If you work on that, really key on that, everything else will follow.
You can move about
that's
the
right.
cabin.
Well,
if
we talk about boxing. Yeah. Golf,
you can get out of the
baseball,
way, you can get in and get what you need and get out.
That's right. Everything else will follow after that.
All right, who's with you today?
I have Janet with me. She
Janet! Janet's in the house.
Listen, I mean, I'm glad she's here because people make so many excuses about being in shape. She has four kids, but she makes sure she comes to my class and take care of herself.
All right.
You love your family, you love everything else, but you have to take care of yourself so you can be there for the loved ones.
There you go.
So, I mean, she puts that work in. I'm proud of her, you know?
Thank you, Janet. Let's do it.
All right, so we're gonna just do a little stuff for my class. So DJ, you can just start it, man. Two here, 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 two here. Go, go, let's go. Twist that body. Let's go, Bob. Let's go. Let's work. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's get it, baby, go here. One, two, let's go. Get it, push. Let's go. Get it, go. Take the rest, I'm going to get that squat. Get it, go. Let's go get it. Let's go get it. Squat down. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Throw that under here. Let's go. Get it. Go. 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 Keep that going. Go. Go. Work. Work. That paper, MOB when it comes to hoes in a bunch cat when it comes to hate, y'all think players not counterfeit. Got a thousand of beans with a bubble kit. Got hoes at the HK doing the tricks. Out there in the track trying to make me rich. I'm too legit to quit. Stacking up that dope until I'm gone. So I'ma be rolling with wheel and kill splinters right now. 20 inches up here. Let's go. Boys talking to me. Work that core twist. Let's go. Get it going. Let's go. Let's go, Bob. Come on, you can do this part. Go, go, get it. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Bring that out. Go. Here. Bring it out. Seals with them foes. Let's go. Boys, they still learning. Get it. Go. I'm still earning. Get my bread while I shake the bring bread. It up. Dimes in and out my get bed. It. Go. The drop to convert the top and go. Little Bob old candy let's red. Go. Get never seats with that wood. Get it. Go. They don't know what my hood. Let's I. Go. Don't take the young guns. Get it. I'm playing the ball and steal. Let's go. Haters off in my mix again. Here. Bros plus pimping beans. Here. Supplying, I got a win. Keep that ice looking clear. Get that elbow here. The roof still chunking deuce. Hot slab and dropping juice. Work. Diamond grill with better skill. Just work. Push mic and I keep that going. Go. Independent steel. Chasing bucks. 22s on bullshit trucks. Go. No chicks with them big old butts. Go. No plans with them switch big old nuts. Go. Hit the club with my get game it. Tight. Go. Bopping my brain right. Get a thing the go. Same night. Boys talking it's so hype. Work. The check when I go. Run my mouth. Go. Roll the green like I'm go. Playing golf. Clap it up, baby. Clap it up. Be going off. Representing the north and south. I chugged up the juice. Let's go, DJ. Boys talking about it. Let's get it, DJ. Next one, the other one, DJ. Let's go. Gotta put the other one on, baby. All right, we'll rock with it. Swing it around. Let's go. On the ground. Right here, we're gonna lean back and work our abs. Look up. Let's get it. Go kick. Go, go. Go, go, both legs, pull, go, work, go, go, get it, get it, get it, other thing here, go, ha, go, work, 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 go, go, both legs, pull it, let's go, get it, go, 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 back to the kicking, let's get it, let's go. Get it, go, work, work, go, 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 one leg, pull it, go here, go, 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 work, switch that up, let's go, get it, go, work, go, go, on your back, baby, get that crunch, let's go, get it, go. Go, work, 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 clap under, let's go get it. Go, work, work, get it. Go, go, hit that bicycle, get it, let's go. Go, work, work, go, go. Clap it up, baby, clap it up, clap it up. DJ, you control it, do I have another one? I guess not. We good, baby. I had another one for you that was awesome, but it's okay. I'll do it next time.
That was a lot of hard work, but you got to start somewhere.
Beautiful. You got to start man, somewhere. From the lights.
What do you tell the people who haven't done anything in a long time and you want to get them? I'm acting like I'm breathing hard.
Nah, that's all
and right. Then you know, they want to get back into it. What do you? How do they start?
You got to start to get it going. You have to start, period. I mean, you too many people a lot of times, they always making excuses like, oh, I'll start tomorrow, or I'll start next year, or I'll wait for New Year's resolution, or I'll wait for after the holidays. I mean,
but they can't go all out like you guys.
No, it doesn't matter.
They got to do a little something.
I say it all the time, 15 minutes a day will get you there.
There you go.
Trust me.
Can they start out with 5 and then add, go to 10?
Of course. Of course, you have to do something.
Yeah.
You just like have to brush your teeth. I hope you brush your teeth every day. Do stuff like that. You have to work out
every day. That's a little exercise.
Yeah. But you got to incorporate that in your daily activity. It's that important. It's that important. We're not young anymore where they made us run outside at school and stuff like that, you know? You have to put that into your daily activity.
So what do you recommend? How about eating? Eating habits, sleeping habits?
Of course, eating is very, all that is very important. I always say your biggest meal should be breakfast. You eat for what you're about to do. Don't eat and say, oh, I accomplished something and you just load up.
Oh, you know,
if I need to get from
it.
Here to there, I'm going to put something in my system that's going to get me.
I got it. I got
not
it.
Just work out. Oh, I did it. Feed
I got it. So if you have an empty tank, you go to a gas station, right? You fill up with some maybe high test if your car takes high test, and then you run your car.
There we go, baby.
Because if you don't put anything in it, the car won't run.
Right. And like I was saying earlier, where you have some people, the old traditional steak and potato dinner makes no sense because you're about to go to bed an hour, sometimes even less than that.
Now, that's a mistake a lot of people make. They
eat before they go to bed. It's not so much the protein from the steak, it's the complex carbs. Your body works so hard to break down complex carbs. That's the starchy stuff, and that's what turns the fat. I mean, you're not going to do
I'm guilty
anything.
Of that, too. I'll grab
you
a snack.
Eat that in the morning.
I'm sleepy.
You know? I mean, think about it. I always say marathoners, just before, like the New York City Marathon, what do they do the night before?
Pasta.
Load up on pasta because it stays in your system so long, and it gives you energy. So that if they didn't have that in their system, they would pass out.
Yeah.
So why would you do that before you go to bed? Makes no sense.
Hit that brick wall before you
right.
can get across the bridge.
That's right.
So, where do you work out? You're in the park?
I'm
you're
everywhere.
Indoors.
I'm at Van Cortlandt in the Bronx. I have my business up in White Plains, New York. I run classes every single day, numerous times a day, morning, afternoon, evening, weekend.
So you start
holidays.
Off in Van Cortlandt Park?
Yes,
and then,
sir.
And what do you
I'm
doing?
Everywhere. Yeah, you just look around. You'll see me jumping around somewhere. So, but yeah, I keep it going, man. I mean, I love what I do. I really love to help people and motivate them. And I get just great joy out of it when I see people changing their lives.
Hey, how did you start that? You know, you've been doing it for a while. You're a court officer.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you wear the white shirt, you get the badge. And
I wear the blue shirt. I mean, I'm not a sergeant, so, you know, but it's all good.
Well, I'm just throwing it out there because you can be sergeant next and then loot and then captain.
I'm fine where I am. No, but I started, my cousin got me into it. He got me into getting into shape, and I loved doing it. I always wanted to take it to that next level, in which I did. So when they called me through the academy for the job, that's a part of PT, physical training, which I love so much.
Like a boot camp.
Yeah, there we go. And a lot of my fellow officers were saying, oh, man, I need to get through this, about the push-ups and the sit-ups. And all I did was just show them what I know and motivated them. And they're like, wow, you have a gift. So took it from there, worked at New York Sports Club. So, you know, I could do this on my own. No disrespect to them, but I could do it on my own.
Now you have your own company called?
That's right, baby. Not playing fitness. Get that. That's what I'm about. But it's good. I'm very blessed with a lot of awesome people. I mean, they make my business build. You know what I mean? They're the ones that do it.
There you go. Give Tracy not a big round of applause, everybody.
And you can reach me, notplayingfitness.com. You can reach me on Facebook, Tracy Jimmy Knott. You can reach me on Twitter, Not Playing Fit. Instagram, Not Playing Fitness. Google, Not Playing Fitness. You'll see me. Come through. I promise you I'll get you in great shape. Oh, Janet, baby. She's here. Thank you for her, too.
Janet, thank you so much. Give them both a big round of applause, everybody. Great job, Janet. Great job.
So,
all right. We have to take a quick break right here, but stay tuned. We'll be right back with more Open next.
It's me, Artie. Come see what I collected from the Creative Galaxy in my idea box.
Transform your world.
Will you help me make art?
Each one of our journeys keeps us.
Before you throw it away.
Hey, I have an idea.
Think outside the box.
We'll never get older. Each one. Go be amazing!
Give your cardboard box another life. Recycle.
It takes less than 1 minute to find out if you may have prediabetes. You can do it here. But you probably won't. You're busy. Kids, work. Show coming back in 48 seconds. So let's do this now. Hold up one finger if you're a man, women, zero. Three more fingers if you're over 60, two over 50, one over 40. If you're not sure, keep in mind you're sitting on a couch right now, so one more finger if you're not very active. One finger if yes, zero if no. One yes, zero no. Next, find the body type that looks most like you and hold up that many fingers while I look around awkwardly. And that's it. If you're holding up five fingers or more, you probably have prediabetes. Sorry to be so blunt, but hey, you're busy. Just go to the site.
Hey, welcome back, everybody. You know, the face-to-face Africa Face, well, it has a list of awards, and it took place highlighting trailblazers in our community. Let's take a look.
Hello, and welcome to the 16 Facelift Awards. My name is Sandra Apia, and I am here in New York City at what is the biggest night in Pan-African achievement.
The Facelist Awards pay homage to a select group of Pan-Africa's trailblazers. In doing so, the honorees chosen have become a beacon of leadership in their selected careers on a global scale. This year's list of extraordinary honorees include Editor-in-Chief of Essence Magazine, Vanessa DeLuca.
We must use our platforms not only to entertain, but also to educate.
Renowned Ethiopian chef Marcus Samuelson.
So don't believe what anyone says. Dream and dream big. Find a mentor in this room.
Grammy Award winning musician Wyclef Jean.
You work that sacrifice. Yeah. Yeah.
Founder and CEO of the Whitaker Group, Rosa Whitaker.
Africa will become an economic powerhouse, powered by African education, innovation, ideas, and entrepreneurs. And I also believe that this is no longer a dream, but increasingly a promise.
Founder and Chief Investment Officer of Kuramo Capital, Wale Adioson.
Let me begin by thanking Face-to-Face Awards, Sandra and the board, for nominating Kuramo Capital and myself for this leadership award.
And the recipients of the Ubuntu Award for Outstanding Service, Siegel Family Foundation.
It means a ton to us. We started doing this work 4 or 5 years ago, and we've helped so many deserving people. We feel like we're really doing a really good job, and to be recognized by Face-to-Face Africa for the work that we're doing.
So working with entrepreneurs, working with individuals across the globe, because we are a global company, is so much a part of what we do and what we support. It was a natural. It was very organic for us to support this.
It means a whole lot. It's to it's the leadership incorporate boards, and it's a recognition of all the work we're doing at Kuramo Capital, which is trying to bring capital back to the African continent.
Well, I am truly and profoundly honored to be recognized as a trailblazer by such a trailblazing organization like Face to Face.
So I am receiving the Media Award, which I think is phenomenal. I'm so honored and so blessed to be receiving this tonight, representing an entire constellation whose mission it is to make sure that our stories are told.
If I would bring up all the people that made been part of my journey, it would be just as big as my tribe in Ethiopia. No one made it on their own, and it's very important for the next generation to think about, seek out mentors, work hard, and always stay positive. You never know who's gonna open the next door for you.
I mean, it's great. You know, I take it, first of all, you know, I bring y'all, you know, love from my country of Haiti, you know,
absolutely,
the first place. And I just feel like I'm just really getting started because there's so much work to do around the world. So I'm just glad that y'all recognize what we're doing and I recognize what y'all doing.
Won't you help me sing?
Sounds of freedom.
to just to bring a lot. You shouldn't stage your ass a home, cause the London voice they hear. I can get stated, then that means the men go. You all alone, Charlie. These are the days, group of fam never missed us. Bush skater, wood man, a super soul sister. But I gotta say, looking back in the day, nobody shook a cry quite like Acapulco Bay. Well, some things change, and some might not. But when I reminisce, hey!
So there you have it. It's been a great evening. I am ready to get in there and enjoy the show. So I invite you to join us here in New York City for next year's edition, 2017 Faceless Awards. It's going to be bigger and better. It always is. So see you next time.
Welcome back to Open. It's time now for Music Mondays. Yes, indeed. Today's Music Monday stage features the empowering and spiritual sounds of Valerie Boyd. We welcome you.
Thank you.
Mwah. Here we go, Valerie Boyd.
Tossing on a sea of strife, you need someone. If you feel so all alone and your house is not a home, you need someone. If it seems life isn't fair when there's no one to share all those lonely days and nights, when things don't seem to work out right, and you want somebody to care, and you want somebody to be there, you need someone. I'm gonna tell you who it is. I give you Jesus.
Jesus.
He's the peace that passes all understanding. I give you Jesus. Oh, he's the perfect love that casts out your fear. Everyone of your fears, I give you Jesus.
Jesus,
he's the water that you drink, and you never thirst again. I give you Jesus.
Jesus,
you out there in TV land. Oh, I give you Jesus. Listen. When the pressure is all around, keeps your spirit to the ground, you need someone. If your body is a wreck with pain, in your health you can't regain, you need someone. If there were times that you have tried with all the strength you had inside, and it seemed that you would fail, you've got to remember Jesus was nailed for all of your bitterness and your grief. He's here in the studio to give you sweet relief, for he's that someone that you need. I give you Jesus.
Jesus.
He's the peace that passes all understanding. When it seems like no one cares, no one even understands you, I give you Jesus. Oh, he's that perfect love that casts out your fears. Everyone of your fears, I give you Jesus. He's the water that you drink, and you never thirst again. Hey, I give you Jesus. Oh, my friends that I'm singing to today, I found out that can't nobody love you like Jesus can. Not your mother, not your father, not your lover. I said nobody. No. Nobody can love you like Jesus.
Yeah. Woo. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Pretty glasses. Look at that.
Thank you.
All right, so you've been singing for some time now.
Yes.
Valerie Boyd, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
Started at age three?
I started at the age of 3 years old. I was, I was raised by my grandparents. My grandfather was a Baptist preacher. And singing runs in my family. My mother was a singer. Mm-hmm. And back in the day, she loved all that Mahalia Jackson stuff.
Yes.
You know, like
yes.
That old stuff, you know. The stuff that gets you through the night, that gets you to know that you can make it no matter what's going on in your life.
So
old school music.
Yeah, so this is in your blood since
it's
age
in my blood.
Three in yes, North Carolina.
North Carolina.
Then what happened from there?
Then I began to sing and, that I was doing more singing than I was talking. You know, because singing runs in my family.
That's how you do it, though.
Oh, yeah. And so my grandfather had 16 children, and 14 of his children, they were all musical singers, piano players, and organ players, and guitar players. So it was all a part of me.
Then you went to school, high school?
Then I went to high school. I went to Music and Art High School here in the city. It's a very known, specialized high school. A lot of known people. Ray Chu was there, Nat Atley Jr., mm-hmm. who was Luther Vandross's music director, and Noel Pointer. I mean, there was a lot of people, but it was good. Then I went to Hofstra University for music, so I've been in music. Then I've been singing professionally for years.
Yeah, but you did something at Carnegie Hall.
Yes. I took lessons at Carnegie Hall.
Yeah, yeah.
And I was singing opera, believe it or not.
That. That helps you with your gospel, right?
No, not really, because...
Because you have a vocal range that's tremendous. I mean, you can go up here, you can come down here.
Yeah, give it a day. But, when you're singing gospel, or opera, you can't sing gospel. But see, gospel is that ras. Mm-hmm. That... that's...
Yeah.
Opera, my opera teachers have a fit. What are you doing? But it's all about the singing.
But what if you did something different? You added a little opera?
Oh, no.
Don't mess
with me, because I will bring the bridges together. Because I just love music. I love challenges.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I'm excited.
You have something special coming up.
Yes, Bob.
You're going to record for the first time live.
Yes. Well, it's not the first time. 18 years ago, I did a live recording. And since then, doors open up. I'm doing a live recording on September 30th at the United Palace Theater.
Right, we know you got your CDs out and all that stuff.
Uh-huh.
But for the first time live. In 18 years,
In
right?
18 years.
Yeah,
in 18 years. I'm excited because you get things live that you don't get in the studio.
Yeah, yeah.
You feel the audience, they feel me, and they pull on me, and I pull on them, and it happens. And then, of course, Jesus, he's in the midst, and you just flow. You just go with the flow.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But I'm excited. So it's September the 30th at the United Palace Theater, which is 4140 Broadway in Spanish Harlem. It's the fourth largest theater in New York City.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm excited. Yes, I am.
I see something gathering up.
Yep, it's gathering on that Friday night. I need my glasses, y'all. I'm at that age.
There
I don't
you go.
Look like it, but yeah,
it look
glasses.
Good, though. Look
really?
Good.
Mm-hmm. Yes, so that night we are going to be doing our thing, and the place seats 3,400 seats.
Mm.
And this theater, they always have the Adeles there, the John Legends there, the Kelly Prices there, the Maxwell. I'm the first gospel recording
first
artist that's ever doing anything there, and I'm excited. And I would love for you to come.
Mm-hmm. It's going to be big.
It's going to be big. And I would love to see your face in the place. All roads is leading to 4140 Broadway and 176th Street.
I don't care
how you get there.
Yeah, so this is like a new beginning.
Yeah. A new beginning. That's what you said, Bob. And I felt that when you said that.
Yeah.
But I'm excited, so I just want to see your face in the place.
Can we go to your website?
Yes, you can go to my website, which is valerieboyd.net, or you can pull up Ticketmaster.com.
Mm-hmm.
First time I've been on Ticketmaster, so I'm excited.
Yeah,
it is really a new beginning for real.
This is just the beginning.
Oh, and we're gonna have some church. Those of you that like church, foot stomping, you know, tambourine playing, drum playing, you know what I'm saying? Oh, we're gonna have some church, but it ain't gonna be the same unless you're there. I want to see your face in the place. I'm looking for you to come.
Can you sing us another song?
Yes, I can.
Let me do this first. Where can we go? Give me your website one more time.
Okay, the website is valerieboyd.net. And of course, Ticketmaster.com.
Yeah, but you're also at a church. Your home base is a church.
Oh, yes, right. My home base, my home church is the New Greater Bethel Ministries, which is 215-32 Jamaica Avenue. It's my husband's ministry. My husband is the pastor.
Pastor Boyd. Lots of good things happening there, too.
And I guess I'm first lady. Okay.
You are the first lady.
My first lady that has something that I do outside of my church, which I'm excited about.
Yeah, well, we'll
and
be
Bob,
looking
you know,
forward
we
to
go
seeing
way
that.
Back. We've been working together down through the years, different barrels going, whatever. Mm. We love it.
She's worked with everybody, TD Jakes, everybody.
Yeah, exactly. And I do a lot of outreach.
Mm-hmm. Wheelchair charities.
The wheelchair charities. I go into rehab programs that brothers and sisters that are trying to make it. And nursing facilities.
All that stuff.
Prison ministry.
And that's all on your website.
All on my website.
Unfortunately, Valerie Boyd, that's all the time we have for today's show. I'd like to thank all of our guests, for joining us, and you, our viewer, for tuning in and checking it all out. If you missed any part of today's show, well, you can tune into Recablecast of Open at 5 and 10 p.m. or watch anytime on the web at BronxNet.org, or you can catch an all-new episode Wednesday at 10 a.m. with our host, Darren Hyme. From all of us here at BronxNet, have a great and enjoyable day. And always remember this, what you are is God's gift to you, and what you make of yourself is your gift to God. To choose your choice. Let your choice control the chooser. Catch you on the radio, 107.5 WBLS. I give you Valerie Boyd. Take us home.
I want you to know that you can make it. No matter what you're going through, you can make it. This is to you that are listening to the sound of my voice, even you that's in this studio. When the world says no, and the odds are against me, I lift up my head, for I know my God is with me. No matter what it looks like now, my brother, when everybody says you can't, just remember, you gonna say, yes, I can. Yes, I can. Oh, my sister, yes, you can. I won't give up. No, 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 no. I'm gonna make it. Yes, I can. Oh, you can make it. You that are home, you may be sitting in that hospital, wherever you may be. Listen. When the world says no, and the odds are against me, I lift up my head, for I know God is with me. No matter what it looks like now, when everybody says I can't, I say yes I can. Come on. Yes I can. Yes, I can. Listen, it may look like I'm never gonna make it through. You may say that nothing good is ever coming to you. So never mind the problem. I got the greater one inside me. Oh, yeah. And I don't have to fear. When the world says no, and the odds are against me, I lift up my head, for I know.